Yeah, I'm reading now from the book of Colossians, chapter 2. For I would that you knew what great conflict I have for you, and for them that are Laodicea, and for as many as not seen my face in the flesh, that their hearts may be comforted, being knit together in love, and unto all riches of the full assurance of understanding, to the acknowledgement of the mystery of God, and of the Father, and of Christ. Or like for one moment, that we stop here, we have to see this verse, Colossians 2:2, on this big Bible, Colossians 2:2. Colossians chapter 2, verse 2. That their hearts might be comforted. The Holy Spirit brings comfort to your heart if you are a believer, if you are reading, studying the true word of truth, the King James Bible. You are saved because you're a believer. You have believed the gospel of Christ, 1 Corinthians 15:1-4, the death, burial, resurrection of our Lord Jesus Christ, who died for our sins and was risen for our justification. The Holy Spirit wants to bring comfort to our hearts. Why? Life is tough. Life in this planet can be sometimes unbearable for various reasons. You might have physical problems, you might be sick, you might have psychological problems disturbed in your mind, you might have other practical problems like, you know, financial problems, work problems, problems. On top of that, you live in a world that is in opposition to God and His Christ and His Word, in opposition to the ones who believe in God, in His Christ, in His Word. You need comfort. So Paul is praying for the Colossians, but this prayer extends to us in 2015. Today happens to be the 28th September 2015. The entire religious world is freaking out because of the big red moon over Jerusalem or whatever, thinking that, you know, the end of this system of the world is today, tomorrow. No. Till the body of Christ is on planet Earth, the end is not coming. Nothing prophetic is happening in this dispensation of mystery, in this dispensation of the grace of God. The two things are in contraposition, in contradiction, so to say. If you have prophecy, you don't have mystery. If you have the revelation of the mystery, you don't have prophecy. After that, the body of Christ is going to be taken up and away from this planet. Sorry. When the Lord Jesus Christ comes back in the air and calls us to Himself, this is called the rapture, okay? Even though this word is not in the King James Bible, but is in the Latin Vulgata, from rapiemo in Latin. Anyway, it's the great catching up, catching away from this planet. Until that, no end is coming. Get this. You get this comfort. The Great Tribulation is not happening now. It's not happening tomorrow morning. It's going to happen, yes. 100% sure, because God said it, and that's it, man. You can't go against the Word of God. But you got to know how to rightly divide the word of truth. You got to know that since the Lord, the risen Christ from heaven, coming in the regions of the air, eh? Met with the Apostle Paul and called the Apostle Paul and practically called him, saved him by grace, okay, and commissioned to be the apostle of the Gentiles and gave to him the revelation of the mystery, the gospel of grace, until now and until as long the Lord pleases, you will not have the end of the world like everybody thinks, neither the happening of the great tribulation. But you have a moment, day by day, where God is offering grace and peace. He is offering salvation to all men. At this moment, God has not got a special nation, Israel in the Middle East, or the United States of America, everybody says to be a Christian nation, whatever it is, because God is not dealing with nations in this dispensation of the grace of God, but is dealing with individuals through the preaching of the word, the truth rightly divided, through the preaching of the glorious gospel of Christ, which is offering salvation, the free gift of salvation, to all men. And you should be happy, because we're still in a period of grace. God is not imputing sins. Please read 2 Corinthians chapter 5. Go on down to verse 12, 13, 14. And see that not only God is not imputing sins because he imputed them to Christ when he was on the cross paying for our sins, but he's offering through his ministers of grace, ambassadors for Christ and ministers of reconciliation, is offering a message of be reconciled to God. There is no need to do anything religious here. There is no need of popes, priests, pastors, intercessors, prophets. There aren't any. Every believer in the Lord Jesus Christ is enlisted, knowing or unknowingly, into this army, so to say, spiritually speaking, of ambassadors. An ambassador is somebody that speaks on behalf of somebody else who sent him. You know, you can be the ambassador, Australian ambassador in Italy for Australia. You speak for Australia. So if we are ambassadors for Christ, we speak for Christ and we say, we beseech you, as Paul said, be reconciled to God. How, you would say? And here jump the religious walls and say, oh, you got to do this and this and this. It's nothing that you have got to do, but what God has already done by the cross of Christ. When the Lord Jesus Christ, praise his holy name, was on that cross of Calvary, among the seven cries from the church, the cross, he said, it is finished. What is finished? The work. The payment for sin has been paid. And Paul says to us that we have received now the atonement, the expiation. Israel is not saved now. He will receive it. That's why Peter preaches another gospel when he's telling to Israel that salvation is going to be brought to them when the Lord Jesus Christ comes the second time for them. But for us, who were Gentiles, who were not under the covenants of Israel, okay, the Lord is offering, is offered, and will offer until the Spirit lasts, according to his will, according to his purpose, grace, peace, free gift of salvation. Nothing and nobody can stop you from that. Not Satan, and not religion, and not, you know, people. It's your decision. Read the gospel, believe it, receive it, be saved, then study the word of truth rightly divided according to 2 Timothy 2:15. Study to show thyself approved unto God, a workman needeth not to be ashamed, rightly dividing the word of truth. Learn the material, be an ambassador for Christ, and tell to your mom, brother, sister, daughter, nonno, friend, foes, whoever, hey, God has provided salvation. You don't need to go through this rigmarole of religion. Call it Baptist, call it Pentecostal, call it Methodist, call it Roman Catholic, Jehovah's Witness, Mormons, all this cauldron of religion, Muslim, Islam, Buddhism, Zen, Confucian. Don't, you don't need this. God doesn't want anything from you. He wants simply one thing. Believe and receive what the Lord Jesus Christ has done on your behalf for as your benefit. Because you see, he's the just and the justifier of the one who believes in Christ. You know, it's not a question that God is permissive. That's, oh, I'm going to close my eyes and pretend they didn't do it. We are sinners by nature. We sin like breathing. And unfortunately, sin has got consequences. Serious consequences. It's got eternal consequences. You are dead in trespasses and sin and separated from God. You're going to hell. But there comes Christ and says, I save you. By grace, like a gift, free gift. Ask yourself, why? Maybe you don't know this. Maybe you've been, like happened to me, so confused from a denomination or various denominations, all this mess that is going on in the world. Hey, don't worry. There is the word of truth. There is the word of God. There is this King James Bible that is proclaimed and tells you that salvation has been provided. It's just up to you to believe it, receive it by faith, by grace. It's a gift. And Paul says, your hearts may be comforted, be knit together in love. This is not Hollywood love, you know, all this pretense, I love you, kisses here. This is not erotic love, you know, pornography and everything. This is part of the flesh. You don't need even the devil for this. This is not this sweet, sloppy feelings that you can feel in your heart. This is the love of God. This is the charity, which is an active love, where God shows his love in reality by doing something on our behalf that we can't do anything for ourselves. Paul says that God commended his love towards us, that while we were yet sinners, Christ died for us. That while we were yet his enemies, Christ died for us. Consider, please, that Christ died for his friends, Israel. And that is written in the fourth gospel when he speaks into his nation, Israel. But then he died for his enemies, us, the Gentiles, the idolaters, the ones that had no covenants with Israel, with God. We were aliens, strangers. Ephesians 2 talks about this. At that time, which time? In the time which the Lord Jesus Christ, praise his holy name, was working on planet Earth, we were strangers and aliens to the covenants of the commonwealth of Israel, without God, without hope in the world, dead in trespasses and sin. But guess what? The moment we believe this gospel of the grace of God, the death, burial, resurrection of Jesus Christ, he died for our sins, he was risen for our justification. He has quickened us together with him. Quicken means risen from the dead, spiritually speaking. We are in Christ. The Holy Spirit work. This is not a work of man. Seals us until the day of the redemption of the body. And the Holy Spirit of God baptizes us, immerses us, so to say, into the death of Christ. That's our baptism. It's no water. Water doesn't do anything to you. You can be water baptized until you are so wet that you shrink. But guess what? You are not going to get saved by water baptism. Even if you say, but John the Baptist preached it, but Jesus did it. Jesus is God. He was identifying himself with his nation because he was under the law. You are not God. I am not God. For sure, man. We cannot identify with Jesus. We are sinners. Do you understand this? We need salvation. How do we get this salvation? By going to church until we become part of the furniture? By paying tithes to pastors who are filling their pockets with your hard-earned money tricking you with the tithing scam. And so because we give all this money, oh, God is going to be all, you know, convinced to bless us because we have given money tithe when we are not Israel. We are not under tithing.